Oh, shoot. I didn't realize that the clock was ticking and we're back. We're back on in action. And I am out of freaking... Yes, I'm completely out. So, it might have been nice. Had I had the blessed masterful rifle, but I do not. And so now, here come the Ganados to come get me. Oh, I didn't get that box. That's okay. I can wait a second. So, as usual, like the chicken shit I am, I'm not going to attempt any offensive... Whoa! Action there. I'm just going to allow my enemies to take all the offensive initiative, which is fairly stupid. I gotta be careful here. Because you will definitely end up with enemies taking advantage of this somewhat complex geography to come after you. Ah! There we go. Ugh, so gross. Thank you. Save myself a little ammo. So the part of this game that's pretty, not the part of this game, the part of this little maze thing is that we're going to be dealing with a chainsaw man. A chainsaw man who likes to take us in close quarters. Now we can hear him right there. Now lucky for us, he's probably not going to come after us. Come down here. And we do a little grave robbing, which is kind of messed up if you think about it. But anyway, Mr. Chainsaw, he's up in the deal right there. He's up in that, like, skull-looking cave. So, we can actually rifle shot him to death. At least we could if I hadn't foolishly squandered all our rifle shots. Now the fun part is, and I failed to see how it's actually fun, but I can just shoot him. With my pea shooter until such time as he dies. And by shoot him, I mean attempt to shoot him. For some reason, this does not draw the attention of any of these other guys, which I appreciate. And that's enough. So I'm pretty happy about that. We actually need to go up there. So we shall. Or at least we'd like to. And of course, this is the return of the bear traps, which... Oh, now you decide you want to actually do something about it? You're a tough guy. I was going to say, is he going to throw that axe too while he has the flog on his head? And he won't, which is good. Alright, so we're going to go up here real quick and grab whatever treasure Dorcas Malorcas had. Now the hilarious part is, key to the mine. Oh, hi. Hello. So I don't want to jump down there. The main reason is because, one, I want to jump on top of a bunch of these dorks. And also, just, it doesn't make sense to do so when I can do this pretty easily. Also, if I go downstairs in this building, because there is a bottom floor in this building, I'll end up coming face to face with a chainsaw man. And if I don't come in the right door, well, I won't get the jump on him, which is really what I'm trying to do here. Ugh. Actually, I can stab these guys. I think a knife actually might do more damage. Ugh. kind of gross. You guys done yet? Oh, hello. That it? Good. All right, we knock the ladder down for reasons, I don't know. And then we jump out like a frickin' action hero. Instead of just climbing down the darn ladder. That fall would definitely sting, I tell you that. All right, so let's go ahead and just off this guy who appears. Yeah, I know, like you've been just standing there the whole time. You are like the most... like he is the most inattentive, like, guard of all time. We've been raising havoc in this room. He's just been kind of standing there with his torch. And then finally, when we're a few feet away from him, then he gets the idea that, wait a second, what are you doing here? All right, so there's the chainsaw man in here. And he's going to notice things aren't so copacetic way too late to be able to do anything about it. Although, I'll give him credit, he was able to get his chainsaw gone. I don't think there's anybody else here, which I appreciate. Anyway, let me just get a few cuts on him. There we go. Yeah, not too much to him. 10,000 pesetas is well worth the money, by the way. Although we could use more ammo because it's pretty low on ammo. That's lame. Alright, so far so good. Could use some more rifle ammo. Could use a lot more everything. The other thing we're really sitting pretty on is, of course... okay, yeah, let's try to get that stationary box cut. But anyway, alright, cool. So, out the door. And that's the end of everybody in here. Like I said, I think it really gets you if you just kind of come upon these chainsaw guys and you really, you really don't know what the hell's... you're not expecting them. That could be a problem. But other than that, you're pretty solid on most of this stuff. You won't really have too many problems. Not sure why there's a frickin' like little box in the... catacomb slot there. So you'd want to use that for storage, but whatever. Okay, so this is going to be a repeat of that other room we saw, except these spikes, it will be accompanied by these little turns. We're not particularly threatening. They could cause you to forget what the hell you're doing. And if that happens, of course, that looked like they were going to fall. But yeah. So it's the same exact principle, except now you have the distraction of two mini plagas on you. Let's actually give you some stuff. Ooh, nice. I don't think I've gotten that one before. I think I always missed out on that one. The old spike coming down room. You know, ever since Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. Temple of Doom. It has been a favorite, and probably since before then. I'm sure George Lucas, because he was inspired by those old TV serials and such. So he probably took his inspiration from one of those. But certainly, that's a nightmarish way to die. I mean, I don't know. Has anybody ever been killed that way? Has there ever really been a trap like that? I don't know, he's very exotic, you know, very exotic and very gruesome, so I'm not really sure if anybody has ever been recorded to have died. I mean, people have been killed by being impaled, but not in that fashion, I don't believe. Okay, so now we're up to a real fun part of the game, and we're going to be riding the crazy train that'll lead us out of here, which is kind of fun, I think. I think this part is kind of fun. I enjoy it. I don't think I've never died on it. It's not too difficult. You just want to stay in the back. So you can go wherever you want in this train. You want to stay in the back. So you hit that. As usual, you have to shoot it. Of course you have to shoot it. So if you want to make this easy, you just shoot these guys before they can jump in. But I didn't do a very good job, so now I gotta put up with these guys. obviously that could be a real problem. But it isn't. Take a chance to reload when you can. Oh, man. Oh, shoot, I don't want to do that. Okay, well, that's fine. So if you kill these guys before the tracks get to them, you know, you won't have to fight them. And then there's a few of these, there's a few beams across the rails, which you have to shoot out, so you can't dock, which is pretty lame. And there's like, like this one right here. So it's cool. I like how they bring you in slow. Like, hey, look at this one. It's pretty, like, I guess you could make this a lot more interesting. Hey, there's something there. Cool. So we're gonna get a bunch of them to jump in here with me, which is fine. I'm just gonna... Yeah, the real problem, of course, is when they start sprouting all those parasites. Luckily, I got pretty lucky with that. We want to make sure to get all this treasure when we can. Obviously, right? Oh, shoot. And it's good, because these are the easiest form of ganados, of course. Yeah, what are you pointing at me for? It's obvious I'm here. You jumped into the cart. Oh, cool. Didn't realize you could do that. Make sure I get all this treasure. Last thing I want to do is miss out on good treasure. Okay, good. Let's use this time to reload here. Cool, and here it comes. Let's go ahead and switch back to the Mac Millie for a bit. And yeah, so this is a lot of fun. I like this. And like I like the other one. Like when you go up the ski lift, you can avoid a lot of these enemies by just kind of... Whoa, that could be bad. Alright. So now, we've got a real baby on board, if you know what I'm talking about. With Chainsaw Texas Massacre Man. But luckily, I don't think he's even got a chance to turn on his frickin' chainsaw yet, which, pretty cool. That's the way I like him. Hey, cool. Thanks, buddy. I tried to avoid him even getting on, but it didn't work. Oh, and here's, another barrier, which I have to be ready for those barriers, and things are gonna start picking up speed-wise. I do like it how the game's not unfair about this. Like, you do get a chance to see what's coming. Oh, crap. Alright, now you definitely... Ah, oh, oh, crap. Okay, now I can't change cars. So those bullets are lost to me, which is a little bit sad. So this is the end right here, and we're going to have to be a quick time event. They jump! Which is good that I don't have to shoot any barriers. Oh, man. And then you got to do this deal right here. Which, I don't know anybody who's strong enough to pick themselves up by, like, a palm grip like that. I mean, get out of town. That is some crazy stuff, you know? I mean, especially even he didn't even have to drop his gun, which is whatever's little daddy-o. And the good part is, like, this brings us out, like, very conveniently... Gives us the Stone of Sacrifice and opens up the way, like, directly back. Thing on the roof? Oh, okay. Like, the way directly back, which is... Okay, that's pretty convenient, you know? Like, hey, by the way... Oh, and that's where we go up the well, huh? Could it be? Where's the well at? No, that's not the well. It's a different place, but in any case, like, that's very convenient. I mean, I'm okay with it, but I mean, come on. Yeah, we just happened to come out there, right where we wanted to be. Like I said, I'm pleased as punch with it. As well I should be. So here we go. Let's operate the lift, or elevator if you like. And you know what, I think that's probably enough for this game. Or for this part. Especially I got to a nice save point here. And we're like pretty much finishing up here. As far as with old Salazar. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.